people, welcome back to my channel. Salut les amis, bienvenue et bon retour sur mes chaînes. Hola, bienvenue de la Ami Canal. Konnichiwa, watashi no chaneru ni yokoso. How you doing for you today? This is another day, another week, and another video of me. As you can see from the title, this is gonna be a haul. I'm trying to not buy as much as before, and I'm really working on adding some fresh touches to my wardrobe because, to be honest, I don't really need much, so I got my wardrobe another way. And I'm gonna have a huge announcement by the end of this video, so you want to stay tuned for that, on top of having any type of outfit inspiration from anything that I'm gonna show you. Before going any further, I'm a size coach and I'm really dedicated to help any creative woman entrepreneur uncover their personal size so they can show up really mad confident on their life and on their businesses. I take it very personally, so let's just dive deep into it. I realized it a couple of weeks ago, I'm over 200 videos, y'all. Like, this is crazy here. I don't know what to say. Most of the stuff that I got here was from Zara, and I got it a bit of last year in December during the sales, and a couple of new PCs a couple of days ago. The second part is gonna be dedicated to books that I got from Amazon, because I've got amazing mindset and motivation books, and I think it's all about starting working from within to get to be able to show anything outside, and how my mindset altogether really changed because of it. The first thing that I'm gonna show you, it's gonna be a couple of accessories. A very cute beret that I got from Zara, like I said. I don't remember the price anymore, but I think it was around $29 Canadian, something like that. If you've been on this channel for a while, you know that I'm really big into berets. So nice warm tone, so amazing for spring, amazing for fall. And I think it's just a really nice color and a really nice brown shade altogether. I think I already wore it like a couple of times already. Get to the second thing here. Great belt. And I got it a couple of days ago actually. And it was so cute. And I was looking for a big belt, because something basic, something simple, but still with a gold accent. Belts are always damn way too big for my freaking size. Every belt that I get from Zara, the best belt that I got to have that I was really very happy with were from Topshop. So this belt, I'm probably gonna add extra holes in it because it's still a bit big for me. Any type of dress, any type of shirt dress, it's really cute when you got to structure your shape even better. $39.95 Canadian. It's gonna be a bag. I've eyed this bag for months. It's always hesitating. I was like, I need a black bag. I was looking for a big bag with some stud and rock and still stylish black bag, but the edges was amazing and the size was surprisingly bigger than what I thought it would be. You shouldn't be afraid to mix match silver accent and gold accent. You definitely can do it. Now we're getting to the clutch part, Not gonna be the most brightest or the most colorful pieces ever for spring, but it's still gonna be a good few pieces that could inspire you even better. This t-shirt! Isn't it cute? Isn't it cute? I'm all about graphic tees. Fell in love with the t-shirt. I fell in love with anything graphic. Love all the little designs. I feel like it's just representing all the different type of beauties you can see out there. But here you have the slick ponytail, you have preppy here, you got the head hair part, and trying to celebrate any type of unique beauty. Much more than the graphic than it was for the representation part of it. I'm so happy. I think it was around $25.90 Canadian. Kind of t-shirt you can pair with a lot of things, with a blazer, add brighter shirt to it, or any type of shirt, just based on all the different color that you can find on the t-shirt already. You can even pair them up together. Let me show you a pair of jeans. Mom fit, mom cut. Mom fit, mom cut. It's like the same thing, girl. Never mind. A pair of black jeans from Zara. It's high-waisted. You got the straight leg type. Bit of a wider hips. When it comes to the jeans, I really discovered and realized that the straight leg pants or straight leg type is the one that fits me the best. But this always an issue. Because of my waist area being really tiny, I got to have that gap. So if you have that problem, probably have a similar shape, you gotta go with the belts, or you can have them tailored. Got the size 4 and 36 reprint size. Looking for a pair of black jeans like that for a while, so pretty happy that I was able to find it, and it was $25.90 Canadian. So just to keep on the black story here, or the black theme here, I got something else for you. Leather top. I dreamed about it. I wanted it so bad, and it got on sale for Christmas time. And of course, I'm gonna link everything down below, similar pieces, stories about it, puffy sleeves or anything structure around the shoulders. I'm happy. Cute leather midi dresses, because this been a trend that went big last year. But this is more like a blouse style, but in leather texture. Best picks ever. I think I ended up getting it because it was on sale, so I ended up getting it for $29.90 Canadian, something like that, small size. Now we're gonna get to something a little bit more colorful here. I mean, it was about time, right? So let me show you what I got. Denim top with basic structure or basic style, but I play around with the texture, and it's probably what I love doing the best, because if you're not somebody that loves to go really full force in colors, you can play around with the texture and the monotone type of outfit. Gotta play with something else, which is the texture. So here you go. And on sale, and I got it, I think, for $19 Canadian. I'm gonna be able to find something similar to it. Much more structure around the waist area and a little bit more crop. It's great for me because I have a smaller torso area. This gives the impression that I have longer legs because I'm not that tall. Contrary to what some people really think when they see me. I was looking for the perfect white button up. Got to find something at Zara that I was pretty happy with, and I'm gonna show you. Wow, God, disappeared. Completely. That was harsh. That's cute one if you get to see me good. The texture is so soft, and what I like the most is the golden buttons. I think when it comes to it, you can wear it with the dress and really wear it as the third piece, or you can have it and belt it, or you can have a nice top over it just to play around with the layers. Any type of white button up could do the thing. I don't need to repeat myself, I love girl accent, obviously. Got an extra small. I feel like the size really big. It's great because I tend to really use it for any type of layer that I really want to, so can't complain too much, but you gotta be careful, because if you have way too many things happening, it could really make you look like your head is just floating around. So it's the perfect length, because it's not too long, it's not too short, so I can use it as a shirt dress if I want to. Of course, gotta put something underneath it, but I can use it for a dress if I need to. I can use it as a third piece as I need to, if I want to, really. Super versatile. The next piece that I'm gonna show you. This dress, I don't even remember if I already showed you that, because I got it for Christmas time on a couple of videos, maybe one or two, I don't remember. But for the sake of just being sure, velvet dress. I saw it at Zara, I feel like they designed it for me, because I'm dreaming and loving velvet. When it comes to any type of texture like that, some people might have reservations. If you have a piece in mind or drawn to, emotionally you feel comfortable in it, change your texture and see how you feel. If you're a shirt type of person, maybe get a velvet shirt just to see, and keep it really subtle when it comes to the color. But it's gonna take you to maybe wear them more than once. I don't think they still have it, but again, I'm gonna try to see and show you similar pieces. Blue, green. I mean, on the camera it looks really blue, I see it's more like green, so you decide. Anything puffy around the shoulders, that's me. I'm gonna add a personal touch, you know, jewelries, the belt, the shoes, anything you're gonna add up to it is gonna give that creativity or original touch or personal touch. It's gonna make you feel even more confident. Sales, and I think it was $29.90 Canadian to it. Okay, let's go. That denim dress. If there's something that I'm really big into this year, I feel like it's anything where the texture is quite different, the leather, the velvet and the denim. Oh, big in love with. And so you can see that a lot on Zara down below. If you're not being careful, not make you be or feel comfortable. There's no belt. It's not super mini either, so I kind of love the length. Now before I get to my book, I wanted to make that announcement. I new coaching program, and it's something that I call the Style and Soul Alignment. What it is exactly. You're gonna get through the decluttering part and the capsule wardrobe part. You can dress your body type better based on the pieces that you already have, and you just gotta make some refresh touches when it comes to anything else. In this program, not only you're gonna learn how to build that through capsule wardrobe, but you're gonna be able to align it with your personal branding and show more confidence online and on videos. A lot of people show up on videos more and more nowadays, and with anything happening right at the moment, you know it's really essential for you to be able to connect with people. It's all about building all of that, building that strong personal branding based on your own personal style, and then be able to amplify all of that through the videos. You just like feel so shy about it and you don't want to put yourself out there. I was like that, and I'm so happy that I got to meet amazing people on this channel, amazing people on this platform. YouTube for me is the best. It's like a little family. If you want to make it really powerful for you, really want to make it strong for you, but more so you want to build up that confidence of channel or any type of video platform like Insta Story, IGTV, get that free discovery call. It has 6 spots available. This is gonna be filling out pretty quickly. It's gonna start in April. Get to book a free discovery call. The link is gonna be down below. Well, was already something that I enjoyed doing. I know we're gonna do amazing things together because you're already an amazing soul. Work one-on-one together for 3 long months. Just saying. Next round, you have a free Facebook group. Now we're gonna get to the book club here. I've been reading more and more, listening to podcasts more and more, because I think the mindset was everything when it comes to the rest. Even when it comes to personal styling, it's not about adding the clothes just for the sake of doing it. You need to have a strategy, and you need to have an intention behind all of it. Make it clear for you, but all start with everything inside and all the stories that we have, everything that we've been through, all those stuff. All the things that can keep us stuck, realize everything that you already have or anything that you need to work on. The first one is gonna be Brené Brown. I'm sure a couple of you already know her. Working on I'm Not Enough, the imposter syndrome, or I don't want to put myself out there. If you didn't know her already, Brené Brown for me is the queen of the queen when it comes to really dive deep into whatever really going on behind everything that we show online and on your own confidence level. And this book is, I thought it was just me, but it isn't. It's not something that I started reading yet because I have a couple of books to read before it, but it's in my list for this month. Look, it's all about learning how to be imperfect online. We have that honestly perfect craft that we want to show online, or just the perfect version of ourselves that we show online, and that's definitely a great thing if you don't want to feel way too much vulnerable, because I think there needs to be a point where you want to share things that you feel ready to share, and if you don't feel like you are ready to share them, that's all good. But instead of trying to overdoing it with anything too perfect and just showing that part of it, just learn how to be yourself and own your imperfections are perfect already. So this book is all about it, and I can't wait to dive deep into it. The other thing is this one, F Anxiety, because obviously I can't say the word here, but you got the meaning, already read it, and it's a quick short book, hours you can finish that. Robert Duff, it gives you exercises how you not see things that you see online as a way to be attacked, but instead of taking things you see online or any type of thing that you see as being attacked to yourself personally as a part of just you having those stories in your mind more than anything else. So it's all about it, and it's all about managing that anxiousness or that anxiety that most of us we have. Amazing things here is gonna be Everything is for Girl the Bomb by Marie Folio. It's a book that I was waiting for even before it came out. I was so excited to be able to get my hands on it. Whenever I finish reading them, I'm gonna get into that as well. Marie Folio for me is everything, because it's much more than business. It's the mindset behind everything happening. And not only that, girl is so stylish. See, she is so stylish. She loves doing it, obviously. It's just a natural thing for her to dress up. But at the same time, she's about the confidence, about anything spiritual. She's the perfect combination for me. She doesn't take herself too seriously. Everybody is gonna kind of take himself seriously when in reality and actually you don't need to be over serious to be able to talk about real and deep stuff. She does it graciously and with a lot of fun. Her soul is amazing. Atomic Habits by James Clear. I got that recommendation from Atomic Habits. For me is a way to change the habit, starting with any type of tiny things that you start doing day to day, because to be able to make a big change in your life, you need to be able to make the tinier, smaller change in every day of your life. Don't wait to have miracles happening in your life if you're not ready to make those tinier, smaller changes in your life and make it bigger afterwards. Talking about any books that I'm reading at the moment, because I'm telling you, that can take up to hours. So I'm currently reading, as you can see here, is Never Split the Difference by Chris Voss. I got this book recommendation from one of my favorite podcaster, Mason Kipp, How to Find Your Purpose and the Confidence Level When It Comes to It. And I listen to the guy almost every day. It's like protein shake in the morning. Everything he says it in such a nerdy point, and it's all about based on neuroscience that happens in your brain. And I studied psychology as scientific, so I love it because it just makes sense for me. In Never Split the Difference, so far it's really about how to be able to be good at negotiating. And the guy was an expert in working in FBI hostage situation. That was his job for years and years and years. And anything that he learned throughout like hostage situations, he took all of that and put it in the business part of it. Much more pragmatic. It's not about just the mindset part here. It tells about the stories, the situation, the episode, everything that he went through when it comes to the hostage situation. And he takes every hostage situation case and there's a lesson behind it. From there, it can help you and really explain to you how you are able to really negotiate and not necessarily waiting for yes, but getting probably to some no's before getting to the yes. That's the current book that I'm reading. I highly suggest the book. Business or anything you want to accomplish in your life, the mindset is everything. And just for that reason, mindset alignment is really big, because you can get to the personal style if you don't believe in yourself. The clothes can do much more than you loving yourself first, because the clothes are gonna be a way to come to meet you halfway. Clothes, they are there to kind of make you feel even more powerful, and even on videos, that's gonna amplify your energy. People are gonna feel that, people are gonna see that. So you being distracted by anything you have on you can be detrimental. You showing up online, gotta think about that confidence part. I can give you all the outfit recommendation, I can give you all the outfit looks inspiration, but if you don't believe in yourself, you're probably gonna wear it one day, probably a couple of days later you're gonna go back to your old habits. For the time being, I hope it was helpful for you, and I'm gonna go specifically to the capsule wardrobe or any type of capsule essentials you need to be able to start building a really well put together capsule wardrobe, especially for spring. So that's gonna be my next video. Until then, I'm probably gonna do a lot more videos. Like I said, I was talking so fast that now I need to breathe off a bit. I can't wait to talk to you. I'm gonna see you for my next video. Let me know what are your favorite foodies spring. Of course, be safe. Don't let the virus thing take that control on you, because we all are scared, but I think at this point, it just kind of get out of hands. It doesn't serve anybody else to keep talking about the fear part of it. I don't want this video to be like hours long, because it's gonna be up to me to edit that. I don't want it to take me literally the whole night, right? So I'm gonna see you for my next video. Until then, be safe. And like I say all the time, comme je le dis toujours, j'espère que vous avez aimé la vidéo. Smile, because it's free and contagious.